Gonna be good. Today, Chef Kyle showing us how to make a favorite easy appetizer, stuffed bacon-wrapped jalapenos. The jalapenos can be prepped a day in advance. Cover them up, stick them in the fridge until you're ready to get cooking. And Kyle, let's see how we do this here.
It's really easy. Yeah. I've taken a jump ahead, and I have our stuffing already ready.
Okay.
And really, to make this, all we do is take about an 8-ounce package of cream cheese, okay, soften it just a little bit, and then add to that onion powder, garlic, dehydrated garlic is fine. I add a little bit of salt, and then what is not on the recipe on the website, but I'm just going to throw it out as a hint. Yeah. I would also add just a splash of Worcestershire.
Oh, okay.
Okay. And then a cup of grated cheddar, sharp cheddar, and then we fold it all together. Just use a spatula. Uh-huh. You want it to be reasonably enough, warm enough with the cream cheese where it can fold. Okay. Then from there, we just take our jalapenos, seed them. This will make 12 regular sized, or not giant sized, jalapenos sliced in half for a total of 24.
And you said something very important, get the seeds out of
Get them. The seeds out. Yeah. Now, some people like a few extra seeds. Yeah. What I suggest on that is, as you're seeding them, save a few and mix them into that, but don't leave all of them, seeds and membrane out.
Okay.
And then, simple as stuffing them, just use a spoon, stuff the cheese mixture into them, and then we're going to do the part that everybody loves.
It looks like you leave it heaping on there. Right?
I kind of heap. Yeah. I mean, we mush it in a little bit.
Okay, gotcha.
Okay, I did forget to mention that Kyle's secret is we also do smoked paprika. Smoked paprika, which you will taste that.
Okay,
so we just wrap the bacon, start at the top, end at the top. And it's as simple as taking a toothpick or a skewer and skewering them to secure the bacon.
Mm-hmm.
They will go into the oven on either parchment paper or spray, a little pan spray, preheated oven, 450 degrees. They take about 20, 25 minutes.
Okay.
You can also finish them with a broiler if you want to crisp them up just a little extra.
Right. So you've got one prepared here.
I made about half those this morning. They're better super hot, I'll tell you now, but go ahead and try them and see what you think.
Oh, they're good.
Not bad.
Oh, they're good.
No frying involved, and I'm sorry Heather's not with us because they would be on her diet. But
I know it. Now, we said earlier you can also put these in the refrigerator, heat them up the next
certainly.
Day.
Certainly, and actually, I think for the cheese mixture, it's a little bit better if you make it a little bit in advance, a few hours, let the flavors kind of meld together. And yes, you can go as far as even wrapping them in the bacon. The biggest, most important thing is to make sure you cover your plate with some sort of...
And how do you heat them up? Just back in the oven?
Make them in advance?
Yeah.
That's actually before you roast them.
Okay.
Now, with this, these are made in advance. You could probably reheat them, but on slow and low.
Okay.
220, 230 degrees.
Well, I can tell you they are good, my friend, your recipes are. And you can find this recipe from Kyle at kylesrecipe@kfor.com. Don't forget the paprika and the Worcestershire, he says,
too. Absolutely.